some story. Here you go. Well, a deal's a deal, I guess. See that? This here is traditional cobra coming out of the skull. This ink was done around 1990. Was my first tattoo. I moved out of my parents' house when I was 18 years old. And someday I'll explain how that worked, but not today. And as a sign of rebellion, independence, and freedom, I just picked a tattoo off the wall. A place down near Arch Street in Philadelphia. I hope you can see that. It still has its colors. You can see it's pretty amazing that it still has its color, actually. Yeah, so you can see the skull. Where this one comes in, you can see this is sort of a drama mask. It almost has the look of the mask or the face paint from the film The Crow. You can see this little, I guess it's like the ribbon to hold to tie the mask. Some smoke effect. And this, I saw the movie The Crow, I think, before I got this. And again, this was off the wall. It was not custom or anything. And there's a little bit of color in the eyes. You can't really see it, though. A little yellow. This tattoo kind of just, you know, it's a mask. And maybe I didn't know it at the time, but masks are a pretty important role in my life right now. Speaks to me, each one is significant, but there's not a ton of meaning, like, you know, anything spiritual or someone passing away or anything like that. But you know, I wanted another tattoo because I had one on this bicep, so I wanted my right bicep, and it was just the right time. I also had piercings. I had a spike coming out of my labret. So you see that hole? I had a spike there. I had a ring. I had a ring up here. And of course I had my ears pierced. And this here is just, I'm not sure what they call it, but my uncle has it on my mother's side. It's like a little dimple, sort of. And then, I got one more tattoo, which is a black widow. And of course, you know, black widow signifies, you know, being deadly, which, you know, I could have been somewhat my temper. but not just that, but I have a love-hate relationship with spiders. I love nature, but I love insects. I used to photograph insects as a hobby, macro photography. And one day I'll show you my pictures and such, but spiders have always been one of my favorite insects. I'm not afraid of them, but they do still, you know, they have that, it's love hate, and I just wanted a third tattoo. I don't really remember why I wanted another one, but yeah, that was it's, you know, it's kind of like more trying to be badass, you know. Of course, that's why a lot of people get tattoos anyway. But, see, it's got the legs, of course. I think it used to have some more color, but of course the color faded. And I thought the shoulder there was kind of a nice place for it. Not too much more significance there. But anymore back then. And so I may look, you know, I'm only 155 pounds. So, you know, but I have an inner fury, if that makes any sense. But, you know, I keep it, you know, I don't walk around. I guess I don't know how to say it, but anyway, enough of that. So, yeah, so those are my three tattoos, you can see. And I want to get sleeves. Sleeves like Geiger-esque, H.R. Geiger type of work, that biomechanic, organic look. So I'm not sure if that's going to happen, but we'll see. All right, well, I told you. My story about my tattoos, as I promised. So, now tell me, once Chris gave you the box, what happened next?
Your papers, please. And what brings you here? And where will you be staying? And do you know anyone there? What is their name? It appears that your papers are not in order. No, they are not in order. Come? I do not think so. We will need to detain you momentarily while we examine your luggage. Before I begin, are you aware of everything inside? And were you the one that has packed it? Very well. Are you ready to answer? I used to be a painter. How long will you be staying? And what is this used for? I see. How do you explain this? I see. Most interesting. I What would this be doing in your luggage? Moonlighting as a superhero. I think not. We all know that the man of bats is deceased. Another mask. I have quite the interesting connection. For contraband or any other prohibited items. It is my business. A sort of puppet? No? Really interesting. You know, it is illegal to transport puppets. You not aware of this? No. I'm beginning to think certain things about you. Smells like my mother. Oh, it is your mother's. And what is the meaning of this? And is this a toothbrush? Is this bubble wraps? Do you have a child or children's? Very interesting. Do you always carry this much bubble wrap? For what are these peculiar plastic pouches for? always carry empty water bottles with you? Some of these tingles are prohibited. We will need to confiscate this. These are some of the most finest tingles that I have experienced. And how did you acquire this? We will need to confiscate both of those. Bottle cap, tingles are strictly prohibited. And what of this? You enjoy playing the bang bang? Is it pew pew? I will admit, when I was a little boy. Oh, it's true. I enjoy playing the video games too. I recorded 2 million points on asteroids. And what video games do you play? What's the purpose of these bandages for? Are you a doctor? No, we need to see the box. What is inside of this box? You did not know. Good reason I should not open this box. It is a gift, you say. And for who? What of this Mordecai? What does he do? This is one of the most finest boxes I have ever seen. My own eyes. Feels very much like my mother's skin. And it smells like my mother's foot. Unfortunately, I'm going to need to open the box. My most deepest apologies. I did not know that you knew him and that you were carrying such a special package. I will not delay your trip any further. Here's your luggage, and I will return the water bottles to you as well. Again, my apologies. Your passport. And have safe travels.
So just like that, he let you go. Did you get a chance to see what was in the box? He sealed it up after. I wonder what's inside that box. Well, remind me next time not to ever go through customs. With a bag like you got, and a box like that, it's quite an ordeal. I hate to get caught up like at customs like that, you know. I'm always afraid I'm gonna tell them the whole truth, you know. Why I'm feel like they're always gonna try to question me, and I hate authority figures like that. They always try to seem to just make me nervous, like make me feel guilty even when I'm not doing anything. You've been on quite an adventure. So tell me, what happens next?